It always takes a while to open the door in a Souls game, so that's unchanged as well. Still more tombstones. Broken straight sword. Not gonna be using that. I had a feeling I could use quite a bit of fireballs. Okay, that was pathetic. No, you won't. And then this guy, I can kill like that. Oh, over the edge. Goodbye. I'm gonna push you. There you go. Spring cleaning. I hear something. Homeward bones. So yeah, homeward bones are used to get back to the last bonfire rested. Bonfires are sustained by bones of the undead. In rare cases, their previous owners' strong urge to seek bonfires enchants their bones with a homeward instinct. So that's the reasoning why we can use those bones to return to a bonfire. Since bonfires are all also resting on the bones of undead. Of lost undead, I suppose. Why are we walking away from that pretty castle? Or is that where we're eventually headed? Anything over here? Oh! Don't jump! Might be able to kick that guy down. Shh. Be quiet. This is really starting to look like the Hunter's Dream, but from Bloodborne. This is Dark Souls! Down he goes. There doesn't seem to be anything here though. Hidden wall? No hidden wall. Okay then. So again, two pots. There's someone. Can't really aim this, but if I can avoid fighting two. Oh! No, you won't. Okay. There are a lot of these ledges going nowhere. So this is the left path. Is there something over here that I missed? Probably not. Well, I say probably not, but probably there is. So it probably wants me to go there. I'm saying probably a lot. Sorry for that. Oh, hi dog. Wow, you look. You look terrifying. He's completely skeletal. I have a feeling that my Estus makes a lot more noise now that I have my ember. Whatever that means. Okay, he was guarding his former master. Oh, another ember, so now I know! Now I might know. Okay, ember. Gain strength of flame, boosting HP until death. Okay, it's a consumable. No enkindled can ever truly claim the embers that burn within a champion's bosom, so that's why we regained our ember when defeating that boss, probably. Because he was a champion. Which is precisely what makes their yearning for warmth so keen. That looks a lot like a humanity that's on fire, by the way. Gain the strength of flame and increased max HP until death. With the strength of fire, the summoning signs of enkindled become visible. And seekers of embers can be summoned to join in cooperation. But beware, the embers may also attract invaders. So yeah. It's actually just the same as humanity. Don't fall off. That's good. We have one extra now. So that doesn't lead anywhere. So head inside, I suppose. There's something on the left here as well. Another dog. I'm holding my shield up. I'm just hitting random things to see if I can't find anything. Oh god. I am a bit afraid of heights, so this whole place is giving me the willies. Oh, we can go up here. I'm starting to think I first need... Oh, who are you? I'm gonna first check out the other side. Anything here? Or more importantly, anyone here? Another ember. Okay, that's great. So is this... Oh, this is somewhere else. This is not where I fought that dog. But there might be another dog. I have a feeling I want to open these things. Okay. Another homeward bone. So I'm gonna go fight that guy after I've been inside here. I'm gonna first check that. Because there might be a bonfire in here, maybe? Because this looks... Oh. Are these those thrones they were talking about? Firelink Shrine. Well, it doesn't look like Firelink Shrine. Is there a bonfire? There's even someone here. Okay. Hello, lady? Are you the maiden in black?
Welcome to the bonfire, unkindled one.
Thank you.
I am a firekeeper. I tend to the flame, and tend to thee.
Ooh, there's a black... Oh, no.
The lords have left their thrones.
And let's first hear her out.
To this end, I am at thy side.
So the lords must retake their thrones. So they abandoned them when the fire faded, and then the bell rang, and revived them. There's also something already on that throne. And it appears to be moving. Let's talk Fashion first.
One, to be unkindled is to be a vessel for souls.
That's what the soul said as well.
Sovereignless souls will become thy strength. I will show thee how. Ashen One, bring me souls plucked from their vessels.
Okay, so that's something that's recurring in every Souls game. So the Maiden in Black will allow us to level up using souls.
One, to be sovereignless.
Oh, that's it! They usually have a lot more to say in the first run. So try and level up.
The darkness within me.
The darkness?
Take nourishment from these sovereignless souls.
Am I gonna put my hand up your... No. Sorry, that might have been a bit tasteless. So I'm gonna try and boost strength and intelligence. Or maybe even faith. Strength and intelligence mainly as my offensive skills. And then vigor. Vigor is still health, probably. Is there help? Oh no, okay. Help, there we go. General strength, let's go over them. Vigor, HP and resistance to frost. So that's what we saw with that crystal demon. Number of attunement slots. I only have one, probably. Yeah, one. Endurance, govern stamina and resistance to lightning and bleeding. Vitality, physical defense, also governs maximum equip load. And poison resistance. Strength is for weapons. And resistance to fire, apparently. And dexterity improves attack strength, reduces spell casting time. And reduces damage taken when fallen. That makes dexterity also something very handy, actually. Intelligence, attribute required to cast sorceries, and spell potency. Magic defense is also calculated from this attribute. Faith, cast miracles, increases spell potency, and pyromancy is affected by both faith and intelligence. Dark defense is calculated from this attribute. And luck, item discovery. Bleeding and poison capabilities also governs resistance to curse. So curse is still a factor as well. So let's go back. Might want to boost vigor a bit. How many do I need to up my attunement slots? 2, so let's do that as well. And then boost intelligence by 1. Let's start off with that. Seems like a nice balance. Not really sure if I want to go with strength or dexterity. That might be decided for me when I find a weapon I like. So there we go. Anything else to say? No, okay.
Farewell, Ashen One. May the flames guide thee.
So they are heavy on fire. So there are a lot of dudes here. So that must be the Crestfallen Warrior. But I'm first gonna meet our friend. Hello.
A pleasure to make thine acquaintance, Ashen One.
Oh my god, seriously?
But a humble handmaid of the shrine.
Isn't she one of those women at the beginning of Dark Souls 2?
And spells. I've lots of little things to ease the burden of a weary traveler. And yes, I'm undead too, but not so charitable as to give my goods away. Ashen One, fetch souls and bring them to me. As is thy wont, no?
Yeah, probably. So there's an Omega on my shield though, also, by the way. It's a shrine handmaid, but I think... there has been a theory floating around on the web that the firekeeper, the mute firekeeper beneath Firelink Shrine in the original Dark Souls is one of the women at the beginning of Dark Souls 2. And since one of those women is back here at Firelink Shrine, I'm starting to think that she actually is the same. And most of the firekeepers are also blind, and she is also covered her eyes. So what do you sell? Oh, you sell embers. Prism stone, so those mark the ground. Oh, you even sell spells. And a tower key. Key to the dilapidated tower behind the shrine. So that's where that guy was guarding, probably. Dried fingers. That's also something that returned. I'm only gonna go in depth with the descriptions once I bought any of those. So a few spells. I might want to go with heal 8 and get myself a soul arrow as well. So yeah, okay, that's everything. Let's talk to her.
If my wares are not to thy satisfaction, bring me umbral ash.
Umbral ash.
With ash, I'll fashion new wares.
Oh.
Is it not our sorry fate to suck Hi. On death?
Interesting. So she can create more gear from ash.
Knowest thou of that soppy gossip? That cordial intrusion layeth the path to embers. And so thou art in need of a soapstone, Ashen One.
Oh.
Thy pockets will overflow with souls to trade to me.
Can you give one to me? Because I think we can use a soapstone to leave a summoning sign.
Ashen One, bring with it.
So Ashen that's her conversation.
Be sure to bring more souls.
I will. Okay, holy shit, this place is big! So Andre, the blacksmith from Dark Souls 1, this is weird. This is really, really weird.
Well, a newcomer, I see. I am Andre. I serve
it is Andre.
The shrine as a humble smith, forging weapons.
How are you still alive?
You're in search of the Lords of Cinder, I trust?
Yep.
Toilsome journey, I'd wager.
A lot like your brother used to be, Lord Quinn.
Let me smith your weapons. I am a smith. Such is my purpose.
Okay. So reinforce, infuse, so we can do everything. Meet a lot, Estus. Oh. We can swap the charges between those. Great. I reinforce. I need an Estus shard, okay? Repair. Apparently nothing needs to be repaired. Infusing is with fire. So I can infuse with a fire gem, but I need the souls. I'm gonna keep it right there for now. Let's talk.
Weapons and protection are sturdy enough by and large, but when overused, they'll eventually break. When their durability is low, repair becomes a necessity.
True.
Use a powder, or simply rest at a
bonfire. Oh, so we can still repair at a bonfire.
But should chance impel them break, bring them me. I'll hammer them back into shape.
Great.
They take no pleasure in breaking, I assure ye. So handle them with care, if you would.
Okay, thanks for the tip, Andre.
There are two ways to smith weapons. Simple reinforcement is one, and infusion the other. Reinforcement is straightforward. It strengthens a weapon without altering its property. Infusion is a more advanced form of smithing that infuses an element. Reinforcement requires titanite, and infusion requires gems. Bring the stones, and I'll do the smithing. It's my purpose, after all. In battle, your weapons are your only friends. Forge them well, and they won't let you down.
Well, I kind of have a bit of magic, too. Hooray! A new... gesture.
No matter.
Oh.
Infusing weapons with gems requires a special kind of coal.
Okay.
My humble coals won't be any use infusing more unusual gems. I know, it's an awful shame, but it's all I have. Oh, please don't give me that look.
I'll try and find something for you.
Not, I'm quite thin-skinned.
I'll try not to insult you, Andre.
Oh, by the way, if you find any Estus shards,
Okay. Come
here. They can be used to reinforce either of your Estus flasks. Without those flasks, you'd want for life or focus.
Oh, focus. It's FPS focus points.
Why not treat them well?
True. But we need to find those shards. He's awfully funny today.
Weapons and protection. But when...
Okay.
When they're,
but yeah, okay.
Thanks,
Andre.
But they be careful. I don't want to see my work squandered.
Well, be careful. Is there anything behind him? Nope. Doesn't seem like a wall. I do want to take a look around. But maybe I should first check out the throne, since that seems to be the focus of this place. There's a crestfallen warrior over here. Well, I'm assuming this is the crestfallen warrior.
Another one roused from the sleep of death. Well, you're not alone. We unkindled are worthless. Can't even die right. Gives me conniptions. And they'd have us seek the Lords of Cinder and return them to their molding thrones. But we're talking true legends, with the metal to link the fire. We're not fit to lick their boots. Don't you think?
So this confirms that the Lords of Cinder still serve the same purpose as Gwyn did, so they all linked the fire, rekindled the fire, the first flame, at one point. So that makes me wonder if Gwyn is even one of them.
What a sick joke. Asking us to seek the Lords of Cinder. We're talking true legends.
Okay. So you don't have anything else to say? So we have 5 thrones. But there is something sitting on that throne over there. So, man, this place is big. So not this one. Yeah, he's alive. He doesn't seem to have legs, but... Let's check him out. maybe around the back, like this. Hello, sir.
Lord Unkindled, and a seeker of lords. I am Lutlith of Corland. Look not in bewilderment as I say. I linked the fire long ago, becoming the Lord of Cinder. If substantiation be thy want, set thine eyes upon my charred corpse. This sad cadaver, no need to be coy. Have a closer look.
Okay, Lutlith of Corland.
Let's talk. Five thralls will take five lords as kindling for the linking of the fire. The fast fading flame must be licked to preserve this world. A reenactment of the first linking of the fire. So it is, I became a lord of Cinder. I may be but small, but I will die a colossus.
So we need the five lords to do a massive rekindling of the flame?
Knowest thou of the fast fading flame?
Must be Link preserving this world. A reenactment of the first linking. Okay, so we need to reenact the linking that Gwyn did in the first place.
Now.
Okay then, interesting. So we now know a bit more about our purpose. So this... Oh, can't I put that sword in here? Oh, there we go. Embed the coiled sword. There we go. Oh yeah, we did it. So travel, attune spell, organize storage box, and burn undead bone shard. What does travel do? We can return to the high wall of Lothric. Oh, and here, Cemetery of Ash and Eudex Grundir. So I do find the name of this land very interesting as well, since we went from Lordran in Dark Souls 1 to Drangleic, and now to Lothric. Seems like a combination of the two. But hey, that's just a theory. Is this going anywhere? Not really sure where we need to go. Ah, Pilgrim, fine work. No fake walls. Doesn't seem to be anything here, okay. Let's head back up and I'm gonna try and fight that guy that was outside first before we do anything else, because I might forget that otherwise. We came from high up, I think, yeah. And then on this side... Yeah, there he is. Oh, wait. Must be careful because the enemies have returned, of course. There we go. Can we drop anything? Nope. Okay, he's not friendly. Holy shit. Fuck. You. Oh shit, this fight is far from over. I'm gonna drink again, because... Oh! Oh, for fuck's sake, I had him. I was greedy. I was greedy, way too greedy. Let's try that again. So I lost my Ember, and indeed my HP has dropped a bit. It's not that much, but well, my shield is pretty useless. Wait, what? What the? Okay then. Why can't I return outside again? This is weird. Why can't I return outside? Do I need to travel it? Oh. What? What was the problem there? So he's still there. Let's dance, asshole. There we go, another parry. Okay, that was fucking cheap. Oh, I'm fucking scared. Ooh, that backstab. For fuck's sake! My shield is useless, by the way. I'm being done in by that guy, seriously. And why is that fog wall there every time? Does it need to load that? What the? That's fucking silly. Congratulations, you've cut down the loading times to walking around times. That's a weird way of doing things, but hey. So, let's kill this guy, because he has apparently killed a lot of people. Another fading soul. So let's fireball the shit out of this guy. Hey dude, you're not blocking. There we go. Need to do that one more time. Maybe even more than one more time. Oh, he dodged that, the little motherfucker. Yeah, I'm not taking any chances now. It goes up here. Don't fall off now. I'm not able to parry that one, apparently. Is he down? No, he's not down. Whew. Now he is. Uchi Katana. Master's attire and master's gloves. Interesting. So let's check that out. What you got, Donna? I can't use it yet. Need 16 dexterity. A unique katana characterized by the fine craftsmanship of an eastern land where it was forged. The finely sharpened blade cuts flesh like butter and causes bleeding but breaks easily as a result. Skill hold. Assume a holding stance to rapidly execute a lunging slash with normal attack or a deflecting parry with strong attack. Interesting. So I wonder, how do you use those? Do I two-hand it and then... Ah, yeah, okay, there we go. Not use it that. Let's go back to one-handed and see... Oh yeah, I'm on fire because of that war cry. Great! Can only use it once, apparently. Or not. Can I use that again? Oh yeah, I can. Just needs a bit of stamina. Is this that tower that needs that key? Yeah, okay. Ooh. Something in there. But I can't get to it yet. Oh yeah, we had that master's gear as well. Master's attire. Terribly worn shirt. Men are fond of weaving tales to explain the raggedness of their garb. My sixth sense warned me of danger, and I danced between flurries of blades and scathed, but alas, my clothes went to tatters. Terribly worn manchettes, men are fond of weaving, blah blah blah, and that's the same, okay. I'm not gonna be wearing that, so I might want to see how that looks. And she's almost naked! So yeah, let's keep my pyromancy gear. And let's head back into Firelink Shrine. And see what other ways we can pick. So we went to the sides here already. Maybe I didn't pick this side, I think. So is this also a dead end? Seems like it. Yeah, does seem like it. So there's Andre, so anything else? I'm gonna rest. And then we'll probably... maybe I should level up. It's not leveling up at the bonfire. It's Dark Souls 3, not Dark Souls 1.
Ashen produced the Moktolothric.
Oh wait, what did you say? Oh, for fuck's sake, I missed that. Ashen one, okay, level up.
Then touch the darkness within me.
Point.
Take nourishment from these sovereignless souls.
I do like the fireball, but I do like the katana as well. I'm gonna start with putting one point into strength and then another one into endurance to even that out a bit. There we go. So that's Andre, that's the other side. Where does this go? There's not one on the other side, is there? Oh yeah, there is. Okay, so that just leads back up, so we'll need to head upstairs, I suppose. Okay, seems pretty useless. Oh, wait. There's engravings on the back of the trunks? Yoram the Giant of the Profaned Capital. So yeah, that's the one we saw, the giant we saw in the beginning cinematic. Watchers of the Abyss, yeah. And the big one. Holy King Lothric, last hope of his line. So that's also someone we're missing, and I don't think he was in the intro cinematic. Saint Aldrich of the Keep. So that was that black goo monster. Okay, there's nothing here as well. So, do I need to head back towards that crystal monster then? Or is there something else I missed? We could go higher. Oh. Fog wall let me out of here, yeah. So we could go out there, so we might as well do that. Oh, and that's that tower that's locked. That's probably the tower. So that's why we need that key from the old lady. Because this is locked, yeah. Okay. Wow. That's a big castle. Okay. It's all of a deserted. Aw. I saw that ladder out of the corner of my eye, but there is that bell on top. We can't access that yet either. So either I need to go to that crystal thingy, or I'm lost already. Don't need to jump off here, so. Oh my god, this tree! Look at it! That's the last giant! Because he has the stone pillar in his shoulder. Oh my god. So wait, does that put the Dark Souls 2 beginning at Firelink Shrine? This is wild. Oh, we can't even examine it. Oh, come on. Nothing happened. The seed of a giant tree is yet to fall. So these were the giants from Dark Souls 2, and I think this is the one we fought as the second boss battle, I think. Because yeah, he has that stone pillar in his shoulder. Okay then, anything else? That's where we fought that dog. So nothing here. I don't think there was an opening on the other side. Press that bonfire and then let's travel. Although I am wondering, so that's Cemetery of Ash. And those were the two bonfires we had at the beginning. But which one is this? Is this one we haven't been yet? Oh, so maybe that's what that sign was saying. That the bonfire will deliver me to Lothric. Oh yeah. Okay. We haven't been here. So that bonfire just sent us here? There seems to be something here. Another warped. Oh, come on. Seems like a miniature Lord Vessel as well. Lord Vessel and a warped sword. A coiled sword, sorry. What does that mean? Let's open the door. Holy shitballs. Wow. Well, that's a sight to start with. But where is this even? Can we see Firelink Shrine down below? Is that it? No, it looks like something else. Could be it. Maybe on the other side. Oh, is that it? On the left there? Oh, those look all interesting. I want to go everywhere. Okay. Let's head in. For a few more minutes. Did I already miss something here? No, okay. Okay. Oh, bonfire. there's something laying there. So that's not creepy at all. Did they turn into trees? Okay. So that's a dragon. Is there, yeah, okay, there's two directions to go. So either go towards the dragon on the left or towards these soldier dudes. Might as well. Nope. That was a crossbow guy. That would bother me while I was walking over there, but I'm gonna check out the dragon first. Maybe have a spectacular ending to this episode. Nope. Are those guys making that noise? Okay, that wasn't supposed to happen. I'm not gonna take any chances. So he's swinging something. So that one's turned mad. There's another one. They're piling up, literally. So this one is still praying. There we go. Can't even properly hit this guy. Okay, this dragon, is that thing alive or not? Seems to be dead. Pretty dead. Another soul of a deserted corpse. Another dead worshipper. They seem to be worshipping this dragon, partly maybe? That's the rest of the dragon, and we can go down here as well. So, we already have three ways to go. Great! Yeah, let's head up first. I think, looks like we can go deeper down there. So let's kill a few worshippers. Does that do anything? Okay, yeah, it does. Running. Yeah, okay, that's not really there we go. Going around for the old backstab. Can I even run into this building over here? Go. Now watch out for the firebomb guy. Oh, fuck's sake. I'm banging my axe against it. So a bit more to the left if I want to avoid hitting the wall. Does seem like normal dudes for now. Looks brittle enough. Kick it down. Binoculars. Ah, there we go. I like the binoculars. It's easy to show stuff, so let's check them out first. The utility is singular, but the applications many. The value of these specs depends greatly on the imagination of their owner. And I like to believe I'm pretty imaginative. So, let's put that here. And now, we can have a nice close-up. Look at that. So pretty. Wow. This place is big. Okay. Back to the dragon. Or what's left of it. I do hear undead still. Can I cut off his tail? I want a weapon. Does look like he's in one piece still. Oh. Okay. Secret. Gold pine resin. Okay, that's to add lightning damage to your weapon, I think. There we go. Very rare, its origins are unknown, although some have speculated that it may in fact be a type of fungal resin. So nothing specifically interesting. So there's one on the right and one on the left, which I might be able to surprise. There we go. Now the one on the left. Not hard to find an opening there. That guy isn't coming in, is he? Can we lure him over here? Try and hit me. Are you stronger than I am? Nope, you're not. So we have a firebomb over here. And a pitch black hole to go down to. So, before we go down there, I would like to take a little break. So I hope you enjoyed these first two parts, because on YouTube this will be two parts for those still watching on Twitch. So if you liked it, don't forget to like this video on YouTube. And if you haven't already and you enjoy this series a lot, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye, and praise the sun! Seriously, praise the sun.